Hey guys, Nadas Commander here with PBR 164. Now this first battle was, well, weird. It was against an Uber user, and honestly, I didn't know what to make of this guy. I couldn't decide whether we knew what he was doing, or he was just an Uber noob. He seemed to know what he was doing, but there was some stuff he used that was pretty odd. But that part of the battle was actually quite epic, because Mercro managed to KO an Uber, which is, like, awesome. Sadly, it doesn't last long due to the critical hit that came from that heat wave from Heatran, so kind of a double-edged sword there. Mercro got a kill, then he got killed off. So that was quite quick, but I do get off the hydro pump on Heatran with Apollyon, which is good, so yeah, so that first turn was actually quite eventful. So I bring in my next Pokemon, which is Bronzong, because I'm using my Trickroom team. I only put Mercro on just as a bit of a filler, to be honest. So Heatran gets switched out apparently, and they bring in their Dialga, and in Heatran's place they bring in away Quasar, and Empoleon gets for Protect, which did help. But Dialga goes for a War of Time and picks Bronzong. I've got no idea why. Yeah, once again, I can't decide whether this guy knows what he's doing or not, but I get my Trick Room up, which is great, because it's always good when I've got my Trick Room up, because it makes my team good. So I've got both my leftovers going with Bronzong and Empoleon, and I go for the Gyro Ball on Rayquaza, expecting it to do a lot, but it does hardly anything. I thought, blimmin' hell, that Rayquaza's quite slow, even on Trick Room. So I go for a Toxic and I poison Rayquaza, but then again, to be fair on Rayquaza, I do have zero EVs on Bronzong and attack, so that could be why it doesn't do much, to be honest. But once again, I thought it would do a bit more than it did, with it being the difference in speed and all, but it does still rely on the attack stat at the same time, because I'll be honest, I actually have no idea how Gyro Ball works, to be honest, you know. So I honestly cannot say how Gyro Ball works. I know it evolves around the attack stat, but honestly I don't truly know how it functions. But all I know is you have to use it with slow Pokemon on fast Pokemon, and that's all I know. You know, honestly, if Giga Titan's watching this, then make a move guru on if Giga Titan's watching this, please make a move guru on Gyro Ball, because I really would appreciate it. If he's watching this, that is. So yeah, back to the battle. I go for Gyro Ball again with Rayquaza, and now he's in range for a Toxic kill, and I try to Hydro Pump, but it doesn't do anything because it misses, and I've got no idea who hits actually. He goes for Dragon Pulse, and I've got no idea why, but he carries Focus Blast, so you know, he used it on Empoleon, so I take it he knew what he was doing, but honestly, I just don't know. You know, maybe you guys could shed some light on this. You know, so Toxic kills Rayquaza off. You know, from my opinion personally, I think he's a bit of a noob, but at the same time knows what he's doing to a degree, but not to the extent of experienced players. So Bronzong sets up Rain Dance, because now that Rayquaza's gone, Airlock doesn't bother me at all. And I just go for the Hydro Pump just to get rid of that Heatran, which is great for me, and all that. So Heatran goes down and back in its ball again. I keep saying that. So DL goes for another War of Time. Is that all it's going to do? He's nearly got my Bronzong though, to be fair on him, but War of Time is just no good a move. Its recharge effect is just too bad. It's just not worth using moves like that, to be honest. You know. But anyway, at least he hasn't got stuff like Rock Climb Giratina or basically a load of Mumbo Jumbo rubbish. Yeah, so I go for the Hydro Pump, and it does quite more than I thought it would, because I've got zero. I've only got like 6 EVs in special attack on Empoleon. And yeah, and I get my Trick Room back up, but in the rain it does still do a decent amount of damage. So funny though, my Trick Room battles always seem to be longer than my regular battles. So I go for Protect, because I'm actually going to explode with Bronzong, and you know, Protect is great because it helps me out with that, and it does a lot of damage to Dialga, and you know, that's that really. So Bronzong goes down after blowing up, and that's it. And it goes for the Iron Tail, which tells me, you know, I don't think he knows what he's doing, to be honest. But I just decided to put it up just because it was quite weird at the same time. Yeah, but I've got no power to follow, so at least it's not totally useless. So I'm bringing Pelipper now, and I go for the Surf just because I want to get this. Do you know, this seems awfully familiar, this does. I swear I've had this before somewhere. Possibly the Getting Soaked episode, early on PBR uploads. Yeah, possibly is actually, yeah. I could have sworn I used Hydro Pump and Surf on a Dialga in that battle, but never mind, that's the end of the battle, so now to move on to the next one. As I'm sure you've noticed, I've been narrating these a lot lately. You know, to be honest, I just prefer narrating them, to be honest, because it's just so much easier to do. You know, but I do enjoy the game music as well, but I have plenty of other series that involve game music, like Pokemon Comparison and stuff like that. So I bring in I lead with Murkrow, and I go for a Sucker Punch, but it fails, apparently. It turns out they went for the Taunt. I've got no idea why people keep using Taunt on Murkrow. I mean, what do they think is going to come out? You know, I've got no idea. So I go for a Sucker Punch this turn, and it does quite a lot of damage, actually. You know, with it being Choice Banded and all. So they go for a Brave Burst, which is obviously going to KO, because Murkrow is really frail, due to the fact that it's an NFE. But fortunately, the Brave Bird recoil locks and Crobat down to really low health as well. But it turns out he's also got a Life Orb, so he kills himself in the process as well. So really, that was a pretty cool showdown between the two flying types. So I bring in Gliscor now, and they bring in their Lunatone, apparently, which I haven't seen in ages, which is cool. Hardly ever see a Lunatone these days. Yeah, makes a nice change. So I go for Swords Dance, but they go for the Hypnosis, which is like, oh man, I totally don't know anything about Lunatone. You know, the only thing I know it can learn is actually Cosmic Power, you know, which I do expect, but at least using a Pokemon that isn't overused, like Hypnosis with Gengar, so that's pretty cool. But I do wake up quite quickly, but sadly my Stone Age misses, and then to my surprise, they go for a Blizzard, which is cool, I hardly ever see. But I didn't even know Lunatone could learn that. Yeah, it does make sense that he has it, because he's a bit of a special attacker, you know, but I just didn't expect him to have it, to be honest. But nevertheless, it's still nice to see. So I bring in Floatzel now, just because I want to go for a Waterfall and get up as much damage as possible on this thing. And Waterfall does a lot of damage, but because of Cosmic Power, he takes it by an inch of health. But I get the Flinch Hacks, which is quite cool, because I had that earlier in an earlier video. So yeah, I go for the Aqua Jet now. I've got no idea why, actually, I just decided to. So I guess, I don't know, I just decided to go forward. So Lunatone goes down, and they bring in their last Pokemon now, which is a Salamence, which is like, great, I can go for the Ice Punch, and I've still got someone else in the boot. But yeah, so I go for the Ice Punch, and hopefully it'll KO. And it does, so great, so that's the end of the battle. So I shall see you all in the next video, and goodbye.